So well, good morning dear students. So in the last session we were discussed that is so significant figures and their rules. Okay, so in this session let us talk about that some few examples regarding that is significant figures. So which I mean that here, you know, suppose if you can have an any particular expression means, so in that expression we would have to so get to know that here number of significant figures. So in order to find out that significant figures in a given expression, so we should have to know some sort of that rules is right. Okay, so based on that rules, so we are going to find out that here number of significant figures which is present in that given expression. Okay, so but before getting to that particular thing, we have to know that rules, so which I was already expressed in that last session. Okay, so but even though I just want to revise one more time. Okay, significant figures is nothing but here thing is that the total number of digit which is present in that expression which are certain. Okay, and which are accurate, by the way. Okay, so the rules are would be like that here. The non-zero digits are in here, you know, significant. Okay, and zeros which is present between the two any non-zeros means they are also significant. Okay, and so our leading zeros are going to be in here not significant, guys. Leading zeros are not significant, and the trailing zeros with a decimal point, okay, with a decimal places in an expression, they are significant. Means zeros which is present at that last, but if that particular expression should have some sort of a decimal places means also they should have also, and you know that significant figures. And so the exact numbers are going to be in here, it should have that infinite number of significant figures, like 2 balls, 20 eggs, okay, 2 books, okay, so 5, you know that eggs, whatever it is, but it should be an exact number. Okay, you can take any exact number, they should have that here infinite number of significant figures. So based on that particular scenario, we are going to calculate here, or we are going to finding out here number of significant figures in an given expression. Okay, so let us go with that here. Suppose if I have some few an example regarding that. Okay, so so this is the first one, and if you can take here the second one, and so this is also, and if you can take yes, so we have some set of thing. Okay, so guys, so we have expression here 965. So how many significant figures you are going to find out in this case? Okay, we have only here 3 significant figures. Why? Because all the 3 numbers are on here non-zeros, right? So 1, 2, 3. Hence we got here 3 significant figures. 3 significant figures. 3 significant figures. So 101, 204. So in this particular case here, 0 which is between the non-zeros or an significant, but that particular expression it has the decimal, hence that, so you know, you can take all the particular figures are on here significant figures, guys. So in that expression all the digits are going to be on here significant, hence we got here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many significant figures here? 6 significant figures. 6 significant figures. Okay, so next we have here, so how many numbers we have here? So let us find out, let us count down here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have here 7 significant figure. 7 significant figure. Okay, so next, in this particular expression 0.00428, okay, we have here. So because these, you know, that leading zeros are not significant, guys. So but after that, you know, zeros we got here, non-zeros. So let us find out that 1, 2, 3. So we got here 3 significant figures. 3 significant figures. Okay. So in this particular expression, so how many significant figures we are going to get? So let us calculate here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because these zeros are on here significant. Why? Because so these zeros are present between that here 2 non-zeros, and by the way, this particular expression, it could has that here, so you know that decimal place. Hence we got here 6 significant figures, guys. 6 significant figure. Okay, 6 significant figure. So in this particular case, so 5, 2, 000. So you just look at that expression. See, that particular expression didn't have any kind of decimal places there. Okay, it shouldn't have that decimal point. So hence only we could have that here, only the 2 non-digits. So 2 non-zeros are there here. Okay, so 1, 2. So 5 and 2 are that here non-zeros. Hence, so these two in this particular expression only we could get here. Okay, 2 significant figures, guys. 2 significant figures. So why? Because these zeros are on here, so we couldn't count that particular numbers, digits. Why? Because this expression didn't have on here any kind of decimal place. Suppose if you can have that here decimal point here, means we have to count on all the 3 zeros there. So all the 3 zeros are to be on here significant on that case. Okay, but still we didn't have that here, so any kind of a digit in that particular expression, so any decimal point in this particular expression, hence we only have that here 2, you know, that non-zero digits are going to be on here significant figures, guys. Okay, so what you just see that in this case, so 5, 2, 0, 0, 1, 0, but I have here decimal point here itself. Okay, so hence we have to count down all the numbers and all the digits are present in this particular expression are going to be on here significant, guys. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we got here 6 significant figure. 6 significant figure. So we got here exact number. We have here exact number, that is 20 books. So which means that, so 20 books or 2x or 20 balls, whatever you can take any exact number, they should have that infinite number of significant figures. So which means that if you can have 20, so after that 20 you should have that, you know, number of zeros, infinite number of zeros. So if an expression should have that decimal point and thereafter you can have that any, so a number of any number, it might be in zero, means so all the numbers we have to count on and all the numbers or all the digits are going to be in here significant. Okay, so hence, so in this particular expression we should have that here infinite number of significant, infinite number of significant figures, infinite number of significant figures. Okay, so guys, this is the thing we have to know about here. So if you can have an you know that rules means, if you can know that rules means, so then it is very easy to identify that here number of significant figures in an given expression, guys. So this is the stuff we have to know all about in this particular session. Okay, so this is the thing. So let us take here some few example, and you just go and try with your own numbers. You just do some numbers and you just practice that. Okay, so nothing to worry about here. Okay, very easy concept is this. Okay, so let us have this particular so thing, guys. So I'm just going to rub right now. Okay, so while, so let us go with that here, another most important concept, that is rounding of the numbers. So what is actually meant by here rounding of the numbers? So when we have to introduce this particular concept, see guys, rounding of the numbers, the term when we have to introduce means, say for example, okay, so rounding of the numbers, rounding of number, so rounding of numbers, so it can be stands for, see, let us go with that here example. Okay, let us consider a substance we have a substance A and it has a mass something 2.48. Something it has a mass 2.48 gram. And we have another substance, it weighs and it has also mass also, that is 1.481 gram. Okay, it has 1.21 gram. That's it. Okay. So, and if you can add up these two things means, so then what might be the answer you are going to get? So 1, 9, 6 and 3. So, and if you can add up, the mass of that mixture would be here 3.691 gram, guys. The mass of the mixture A and B, so individually A weights this much, so B weights this much, and A plus B means that a mixture weights here, mass of the mixture would be here 3.691. We got something like that, something value, okay, 3.691 gram. See the final result what we got here. So if you can observe, the number which is present in that final result should not be on here significant, guys. Okay, so whatever the result, whatever the final result we got here, so the figures which is present in that final result, they are not insignificant. When this actually happens, then we have to round it off the numbers. Then what is mean by rounded off the numbers? What is mean by rounding off? Okay, so the thing is that, I just tell you that, okay. So while rounding off that number, we have to remove or we have to drop out that extra digits with or without minor changes in that figure retained. Okay, so what I mean is that, suppose I am going to rounding off this particular number means, so what I want to, so I wanted to do that. So I just want to, you know, that remove that here extra digits. Okay, so which is present in that given expression. Okay, so it has set of a rules, guys, first of all. So while doing, you know, that while rounding off that any kind of a result means, so we should have to follow some set of rules as we followed as in the case of significant figures. Okay, the same thing we are also going to carry here. Okay, while rounding off the number, we would have to follow some set of a rules. That's it. Okay, so if you can once come to know that rules means, then it will be very easy to rounding off that any kind of a result. Okay, any kind of a expression, which is most important thing, guys. Okay, so let us do with that, let us go with that particular concept, right? Okay, so let us go with that rules of the rounding off number. See, I am telling you that if you can have any kind of a result means, so final result means, the figures which is present in that final result should not be on here, they are not as significant, by the way. In order to make them as an accurate value, guys, so we have to rounding off that number. Okay, and one thing you guys have to know about always, see what is that means. See, if you can have any kind of a result, any kind of a final value means, the accuracy of that particular value should be limited to that here only 3 significant figures. Okay, only 3 significant figures, that's it. You just keep that particular thing in your mind. So while you know that having this particular concept, okay, let us go with that thing. Okay, so rules of rounding off the number. Rules of rounding of the number. Rules of rounding of the number. Okay. So most important thing, guys, so which is very easy, I can tell you that. Okay, so the first rule is to be here, the first rule, it has only 3 rules which are most and which are very easy, by the way. Okay, the thing is that the digit following last digit, the digit following last digit is retained to be less than 5. Okay, if the digit following the last digit is retained to be less than 5, then the digit is left retained unchanged. So what I mean is that, okay, the digit following the last digit is retained to be less than 5, then the last digit is left retained unchanged. So which means that, and C, the thing is that rules is an for a formality, that's it. Okay, once you come to know that how to round it off the numbers means, that's it guys, then you don't need of that rules also, but for a formality we have to know that. Okay, but once you come to know how to round it off the numbers means, then you don't need of these things. Okay, so go with that thing. So we just justify this particular statement right now. Suppose you can have an expression like that. Suppose I just have here 3.64. okay, I don't know, I just have an, you know, that number, that's it. Okay, so 7.364, let us consider this could be that a final result of any particular thing. Okay, 7.364, and by the way, is this particular expression is being a final result and their accuracy has been limited to only 3 significant figures. Okay, but we have to round it off the numbers. Why? Because the thing is that in a given expression, the figures which are present in that, they are not as significant, right? In order to make them significant, we have to round it off that number, right? Okay, so let us consider here 7.364, the number is there. If you can consider last digit, okay, last digit. Okay, so if you can have any kind of a number, suppose let us have 3, 6, 4, 8, 2, 1, don't worry about it, you just go with that 4 number, that's it. Okay, you just least bother these things. Okay, you just have to go with that these particular thing. So this could be that last digit. Why? Because if you can take any expression, the significant figures is limited to only here 3 numbers. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so we have to round it off this particular number. Why? Because accuracy has been limited to 3 significant figures. Hence, if you can consider here last number, this last number which is an less than 5, to be an less than 5, then that this particular digit is there, no, it cannot be changed, it cannot be altered, we have to write it as remains. Okay, we have to write it as such. Okay, so the thing is that 7.364 in this case, and the last digit which is less than 5 means, so that the digit which is followed by this one, no, so this particular digit cannot be altered, cannot be changed. Okay, hence if you can round it off that number means, so then we got here actually 7.36. if you can rounding off this particular number, we got ultimately it is 7.36. okay, so this is the way of rounding off the figures when that last digit which is less than 5. Okay, 7.364 it is there, right? So that 4 which is less than 5, no, then this particular number cannot be altered, we have to write it is as such. Okay, hence therefore the rounding of this suppose we are rounding off this particular number means, ultimately we got here 7.36. this particular statement wants to tell us that. Okay, so let us take down this. Let's take it. So first let us go with that second one. Okay, next, if the digit following last digit is retained, digit to be retained is more than 5, then the digit is retained increased by 1. Then the digit is increased by 1. So which means that, suppose let us have 7.367. I don't know, I have some expression, that's it. 7.367. Okay, again I am telling you that if you can have any expression, suppose 8.362181, like that, whatever it is, but you have to take first 4 numbers. So in that we could have to, you know, the accuracy of that result only limited to 3 significant figures. Hence with respect to this number we have to round it off. Okay, so based on this particular number, okay, so the number which is greater than 5 or less than 5 or which is equal to 5, so based on this particular factor, this number is going to be changes. Okay, so that only I am going to expressing here. This is we can so called rounding off. Okay, so 7.367 is there, right? So in this particular expression you can just identify here the number which is greater than 5 here. Okay, so the digit following the last digit to be retained is more than 5. See here, if you can consider this particular number, means see this number is to be here which is more than 5, right? Okay, so if this particular number supposed to be more than 5 means, so what meant the impact produced on this particular number? Okay, so this number has been increases by 1. Okay, so that's why, see, this number has to be, you know that, so more than 5 means, so this number increased by here 1. Hence we can round it up, this particular number means, so the number is must be 7.37. Okay, so this is the thing. If the digit following the last digit to be retained is more than 5, then the digit is retained is increased by 1. Okay, so this is the thing, guys. So this is the way to rounding off that number. Okay, so you can have any particular expression. Suppose if I have that 8.347218, we have this number, then you guys can have some sort of confusion. So while having this number, then what we have to do? So you don't worry about it, then you just have to focus these 4 numbers. Okay, so then you just see that 4th number, suppose this number is to be, you know, more than 5 means this particular number is been increases by 1. Suppose this number which is less than 5 means, so this number cannot be altered. That's it, we have to write it as such. Which is more than 5 means we have to increase this number by 1. That's it. Suppose the third rules would be like that. Okay, so then go with that. Okay, I want to express that last but not the least rules regarding that rounding of that number. Okay, let's take down, guys. Yes, so well, we have here, if the digit following the last digit is to be retained, okay, equal to 5, then the digit is left retained unchanged if it is even. Okay, the digit is increased by 1 if it is odd. So this is the thing, guys. So we have a statement like that, if the digit following the last digit is to be retained equal to 5, then the digit is left retained unchanged if it is even, guys. Okay, the digit is increased by 1 if it is odd, which means that suppose if you can have two expression, okay, 7 point, or you just take anything, 8, 3, 2, 5. This will be the one expression and another. So 8.3, 7, 5. Whatever, simply you can take that. Okay. So the thing is that if the digit following the last digit is equal to 5 means, So then this particular number has to be left retained, means we means that cannot be changed. When it cannot be changed, even if this particular number is to be here even, okay, if it is number is to be here even, okay, then this particular number cannot be changed. And in this case, if last digit is going to be equal to 5, means then this particular number has been changes. When it is changes, this particular number supposed to be an odd. Okay, if it is an odd number, means then this particular number has been increases by 1. Okay, so in this case it cannot be increased by 1 or anything. Why? Because it is an even number. If it is even number, it is there, means that it cannot be altered. Hence, while we are rounding off this such kind of expression, means then that 8.32 we should have that. Okay, and in this case, so 8.38. Why? Because so equal to 5 means this number is to be an even, odd means then it has to be increased by here 1. Okay, hence that expression would be 8.38, guys. So this is the thing, guys. So we have to actually know in this particular particular expression, in this particular concept, this is rounding of the numbers. This is the ultimate expression, ultimate thing about that, so rounding off numbers. So if you can get to know these particular rules, means then it is very easy to so rounding off that any kind of a expression. Okay, so let us have some numericals, not numericals, so something, you know, that let us find out, let us rounding off that numbers in the case of multiplication or a division or a subtraction. Okay, so when we have to operate that mathematical operations there, means okay, so there we have to rounding off the numbers actually. Okay, so let's go with that particular thing. Okay, so let us please let us have this. Yes. So let us take, guys, calculation involving multiplication and addition. Calculation involving multiplication and addition. Okay, see, the thing is that calculation involving so multiplication and addition, first let us go with that here, subtraction, because it has some rules here also, subtraction and addition. Okay, so what is that means? See, in addition and subtraction, the final result should be reported as the same number of decimal place. Same number of decimal place as the number with the minimum number of decimal place. Okay, so the statement would be like that here. So in addition and subtraction, the final result, whatever may we are going to get, so in this particular expression, the final result should be reported as that same number of decimal places as that number with that here minimum number of decimal place. So which means that, suppose let us go with that here, let us have in addition some, you know, let us take some few example. Okay, in addition. Okay, so how do we get to know this particular statement here? In addition, suppose if I have 20.34 and 10.1, if you can add up these two things, 4 4, okay, 0 and 3. So the final result I should get here, 30.44. okay, this is the final result, but we have to report it what in terms. Okay, so the thing is that the statements are telling that in addition and subtraction the final result should be reported as the same number of decimal place, same number of decimal place as that number with the minimum number of decimal places, so in these two expression, so you should find out number after decimal places where it is got you got minimum value. So minimum number, by the way, so in that first expression after decimal place you got here two numbers, okay. So in this expression here, so after decimal place how many numbers you have? Only one number. So hence it is a minimum number, right? Hence that final result should be reported in this particular form. Hence we have final result, that is 30.4. this will be the final result, guys, 30.4. why? Because after here in this particular expression after decimal place only one number is there. This will be the statement wants to tell us that, okay, hence that final result should be reported with that minimum number of decimal places, okay, as we got here 30.4. okay, so this is the thing, guys. So this is we have to do in the case of addition. Let us go with that here multiplication. Okay, suppose if you can have that values, suppose I have some few values here, so let us take down. Okay, so 6.56 minus 0.031 and we may get here 6.529 value, guys. So I have this value, okay, by the way, okay. So 6.56 minus 0.031, which equals, means if we can simplify this number, means then you may get here 6.529. yes, by the way, here if you can find out after the decimal place, so how many numbers you could find out here? Only two numbers. So in this case after the decimal point how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3. Hence the final result should be reported here 5.52 only, but we have to round it off this particular number. Why? Because this number which is greater than 5, hence so this number has been increases by here 1, the final result should be here 6.53. so this would be the, so you know, the way of rounding off that numbers as the case of multiplication or an addition. Okay, so in order to get an here accurate value, so we have to do all these things, guys. Okay, so this is in the case of multiplication. So the thing is that here statement is telling that in addition subtraction the final result should be reported as the same number of decimal places as number with the minimum number of decimal places. See, in this case after the decimal place you have only two numbers, in this case after the decimal place you have three numbers. Hence we have to express that final result in this particular form. Okay, we have to express, but we should not forget that rounding of the numbers. Okay, while reporting that final result we should have to know that rounding of the number, guys. Thereby we have to put here ultimate value. Okay, so this will be the, you know, rounding of that number in the case of addition and as well as that multiplication. Let us go with that here in the case of this is a subtraction. In subtraction. Okay. So let's go with that. So is that a multiplication? I'm very sorry about that. Okay, is that subtraction? So let us have here another particular statement. So in multiplication and division
in multiplication and division, the final result should be reported having same number of significant figure as the number with minimum number of significant figures.
Okay, so this is the thing, guys. So we have to know, in the case of multiplication as well as the division, the final result should be reported having the same number of significant figures as number with the minimum number of significant figures. Okay, so let us do in this particular case. So in multiplication, now we have multiplication. Okay, in multiplication, yes, so I have some values, guys, by the way. So let us take down 6.26 into 5.8, which equals to, that can give some values, that is 36.308. 6.26 into 5.8, we got here 36.308. This could be the final result. Okay, but so final result should be reported according to this particular statement. So what it is? So final result should be reported having same number of significant figures. It should have that same number of significant figures as that number with the minimum number of the significant figures. Among these two particular expression, so which particular expression should have that minimum significant figure? No. So in this particular expression only we have to reported that final result here. Okay, so hence among these two particular expression, this particular expression, it has that minimum number of significant figures. Hence we have to report it the final result in this particular form, means within two significant figures. Hence that overall result should be here 36 itself, guys, only that 36. Okay, so this is the thing. So next, in division, okay. So in division, if you can see here, okay, I have values 5.27 divided by 12, then we got here some value which is 0.439. again we have to express that particular result, so with that minimum significant figures. Okay, so 0.439 is there. Okay, you can take this particular expression, it has three significant figures and it has two significant figures. Hence that final result should be reported, so the expression should have that minimum significant figures. Hence that value would be here 0.4. but you guys don't forget to round it off the numbers. Here the last digit is going to be here greater than 5. Hence this particular number has been increased by here 1. Hence 0.44. by the way, it has only two significant figures as this number has. Okay, this is the thing, guys. So in multiplication and division, so we have to know that how do we rounded up the numbers with an final result with an appropriate statement. Okay, so this is the thing, guys. So in that next session we are going to discuss that some conversion factor based, so something like that numericals. So we should have to know this thing, okay, which are most important and very easy, don't worry about it. So conversion factor means, like, suppose if you can have a kg that has to be converted into centimeter or a meter or a nanometer or a picometer, whatever, this set of a conversion will be there. So let's do that particular thing in that next session. Okay, so thank you one and all, guys.